Hey you guys, happy Wednesday. I pray that half of the week has been good for all of you guys. You know what today is, and today is Worship Wednesdays, Praying Wednesdays. So today we're going to do some worship, we're going to do some prayers. And by the way, if you have any prayers requests, you can drop them down in the comments, or if you click on my link tree, which I believe is in my bio, or maybe in my first video, it has my email on my socials panels. You can contact me there to send your prayer requests so we can all pray for you on here together. Because when there's two or three gathered in Jesus' name, he said that he's right here in the midst. And it was hard to break a cord of three. So with that being said, we're going to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, and just give him all the honor and praise, because he deserves our praise, deserves all honor, deserves to be glorified, because how good our God is. And when we praise, remember you guys, it boosts up our faith. It reminds us who our God is and who we are in Christ and what he can do. So with that being said, we all should be remembered and reminded that we have a friend in God. He is our Father. He calls us friend. So the song that I'm going to play is by Phillips, Craig, and Dean, and it's called Friend of God. With that being said, we're going to worship and just praise his name.
Lord of glory,
Friends by the Almighty God, creator of all. Believe it.
He called me friend.
And one thing about it, when we sing unto the Lord, as we're singing, we have to believe. And we have to believe that God calls us friend. He's our father. He's our friend. He's everything. The Lord doesn't have counsel, wisdom, peace, therapy, sweet sleep, healing to give. But remember that He is counsel. He is peace. He is therapy. He is our sweet sleep. He is peace. He is everything that we may need. We have it all, and He's willing to give it us all. And we have to remember that. And we have to remember that He is God alone. And with that being said, my next song that I'm going to play is by Phillips, Craig, and Dean, and it's called You Are God Alone. Because God is God alone. He doesn't need our help. Because remember, our works are filthy rags. There's nothing we can do to be holy, to make amends, you know. But the only thing He requires is faith in Jesus Christ and Him crucified. So God is God alone. And when we praise, we listen to the words, meditate in our heart, praise in spirit and truth, and just remember everything that He has done for us. And remember that God is God alone. So this song is called You Are God Alone by Phillips Craig Dean. I love this song.
You are not a God created by human hands. You are not a God independent from any mortal man. You are not a God in need of anything we can give by your plan. That's just the way it is. You're the only God whose name is praised. days will never end. You're the only God who's worthy of everything we ended. You are God, and that's just the way it is. From before time began, you are on the throne. You are God alone. And right now, feeling good times and bad, you are on the throne. You are God alone. Unchangeable. Unstoppable, that's what you are. Unchangeable, unstoppable, that's what you are. You are God alone. From before time began, you are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God alone. Unchangeable, unshakable, unstoppable. That's what you are.
And that is what we have to remember, our children of God, that God is God all alone. He doesn't need our help. There's nothing, all the benefits that he wanted to do when he wanted us to have faith, pray, be obedient, discernment, speaking in tongues, the gifts. It's not for his benefit that will help him, but it's for to help us. So we may know these things, so we can get closer to him, so we may know what to do, what not to do, so we can be guided right to help our lives, to help change our hearts, that help change our souls. He doesn't need us. We need him. So with that being said, let God be God, and just remember that in Christ alone is where, in Christ alone and what he's done, did at the cross, is where we can place our faith. And where, when we place our faith, we don't have to be trust or have to do the work or the act and have to do religion. It's about relationship. Jesus Christ, I'm crucified, what he has done. So with that being said, trust in Jesus wholeheartedly. And the next song that I'm going to play is Phillips, Craig, and Dean, In Christ Alone. And listen to the words.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my life, my strength, my soul. This crown is stone, this solid ground. Firm through the fiercest trial and storm. What heights above, what depths of peace. When fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all. Here in the love of Christ, I stand. Christ alone, my joy of flesh, fullness of God in heaven, made his gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he Jesus died. The wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin that you was laid, here in the death of Christ, I could.
It's the cross. The cross was the means for all things. So we can get to the Lord Jesus. Give us the wisdom of all things.
His body lays, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day. On from the grave he rose again. Then victory, sin's curse has cast its hand on me. For I am his, and he is mine. All of the precious blood. I the Lord, I place my trust, and find the glory in the power of the cross. In every victory, let it be said of me, my source of praise, my source of hope, is Christ the Lord. I place my trust and find the glory in the power of the cross. In every victory, let it be said of me, my source of praise, my source of hope, is Christ the Lord. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hands till he returns. Calls me home. Here in the power of Christ, I'll stand.
So with that song being said, in Christ alone, it really just reminds me of how Jesus paid it all and did it all on the cross. Everything that we may need, when he said it was finished, everything was finished. When he said that we could be more than conquerors and that we can have victory over sin, he meant that we can have victory over death. Because guess what? Without having Jesus, you're spiritually dead. Dying without Jesus, you go to hell, spiritual, horrible death. So with that being said, in Christ, we are dead to sin. We are dead to everything that is not like Christ. And we have to remember that. And we have to believe that we are victorious, that we can live a holy life. We can be the woman and man of God who he wanted to be in Christ alone and what he has done for us at the cross. Jesus in the cross, for what he has did, never can be separated, always put together, and where our place, our faith should be in. So with that being said, I'm gonna play the one and last song called Let the Worshippers Arise by Philip Craig and Dean.
Father, I see that you are drawing a line in the sand, and I wanna be standing on your side, holding your hand. So let your kingdom come, let it live in me. This is my prayer, this is my plea. Father, I see that you are drawing a line in the sand, and I wanna be standing on your side, holding your hand. So let your kingdom come, let it live in me. This is my prayer, this is my plea. Let the worshipers arise. Let the sons and the daughters sing. I surrender in my arms. I surrender to the King. Let the worshipers arise.
Let's arise, you guys, and be with me.
Let the sons and the daughters sing. I surrender in my arms. I surrender to the King. Father, I hear it going louder, the song of your redeemed. Saints of every nation are awakening to sing. From our hearts there comes an anthem. Oh, I hear the heavens ring. This is our song, a song to my King. Let the worshipers arise.
Worshipers, let's arise in Jesus' name.
Let the sons and the daughters sing. I surrender in my arms. I surrender to the King. Let the worshipers arise. Let the sons and the daughters sing. Let the worshipers arise. Let the sons and the daughters sing. I surrender in my arms. I surrender to the King.
Surrender all we have and all that we are to Christ.
Sing a song of praise.
An anthem of praise.
I surrender to the King. And
let, with that being said, let the worshipers arise. If we have Jesus, we should be willing and ready to worship. Excuse me, all the time. We need to rise up as children of God, because Jesus is worth it. He's worth our praise. He's worth our honor. He's worth our thoughts. He's worth our faith. And with that being said, we're showing him that we trust him. We love him. We depend on him. We know that he's our only source and our only way. And to surrender all, give everything to him. What we cannot do as human beings, he did for us on the cross. You have to remember that he is strength. So he is our strength. that we need. He is everything. It's, remember, it's not that he have all these things for us, but he is all these things. This is what he is by the blood of Jesus, what he did on the cross. With that being said, I do want to pray in Jesus' name. Okay. And I do just want to pray, Father God, I just ask you in your Son, Jesus' name, Father God, touch this world, Father God, all the viewers and listeners, Father God. I ask you to touch myself as well, to have us to be the women and men of God you want us to be, Father God. I ask you, Father God, to save lost souls, Father God, to convict the hearts of unbelievers, Father God, to get saved, Father God, to know who you are, Father God. I ask you to remove the dark veils amongst their eyes, their hearts, their souls, Father God. I ask you, Father God, to bring back the backsliders and remind them that you are married to them, Father God, and that you do love them, Father God, and that you will leave the 99 to go to that one, Father God. And I ask you for the Christians in this world, Father God, to have us to stay on the straight and narrow path to everlasting life, Father God. But I do pray, Father God, for each and every one of us, Father God, in all our respective places, to loose on heaven and earth the wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and revelation of Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Please give us that understanding of, Father God, of your Son Jesus dying on the cross, so we may see the significance of it, what it truly, really means, and so we may live a life that is pleasing and holy to you, Father God. I ask you to just keep us, Father God, to lead and guide a nations, Father God, in the countries to hear about Jesus, Father God, because there are some nations that have not heard of you, Father God, but we ask you, Father God, to loose, Father God, your anointing and loose the gospel of the good news of Jesus Christ into these nations, Father God, so they may know who you are, Father God, so they may hear the good news, Father God, and have a hope and a reason to live, Father God. We bless the nation of Israel, Father God, right now in Jesus' name, and bring salvation to them, Father God. Bless them and keep them, Father God, and deliver them from all help, Father God. We ask you right now, Father God, to be with your children, Father God, who goes through persecution, Father God, not only in America, but in all the nations, Father God, be with us. Strengthen us not to lose hope, Father God, while we're serving and living for you, Father God, to be reminded that the things that we go through and the persecution and the trials and tribulations and the temptations that we go through, Father God, have us to be reminded that it doesn't compare to the eternity blessing and the things that you have to come for us, Father God, when we get to be with you, Father God. Have us to be reminded that a short time doesn't compare to eternity, Father God, and that it's never a waste to do the things of God, even if it is to hurt or threaten our lives, Father God, because anything that you allow, Father God, is good, and all everything that you do is good, Father God. And just have us to be reminded of that, to trust you for that, Father God, that whatever you say and do and allow, Father God, is good, and that you have a plan working on our behalf, Father God, and that everything that we do for the Lord, Father God, doesn't go unnoticed or wasted, Father God. Help us to do that everything that we do, Father God, to do it unto you and not unto ourselves. Help us to present ourselves, Father God, holy, true, and in humbleness, Father God, unto you, Father God, in everything that we do, and just bind and rebuke pride and flesh, Father God. Help us all to decrease as you increase into our mind, body, heart, souls, and spirit, Father God. And have us, Father God, to have the faith, Father God, to believe that you can do any and everything, Father God. Help, we believe, but help our unbelief, Father God, our doubts, that we can be victorious, that we can live a holy life, that we can be the woman and man of God that you want us to be, not who anyone else wants us to be, Father God, but who you want us to be, Father God, for your will, for your kingdom, Father God, for your way, no one else, Father God. Have us to understand, Father God, that we're on this life, Father God, for one mission, and that mission is to do the will of God and purpose of God. Have us not to focus on the things that is temporary of this world, even if they are good, Father God, but have us to focus on the number one thing, which is, Father God, to do your kingdom and will, to help bring souls to the kingdom, to help spread the good news of Jesus Christ, because your sacrifice, Jesus, was so significant and big. Father God, help us to just be reminded that that's more important, and that's the fulfillment that we're looking for, that will fulfill us, Father God. Not temporary fulfillments that this world can give, that doesn't matter, that will end with no meaning and just nothing after you do it, but have us to know that Jesus is everlasting, and everything that's in him is everlasting, and it means something and it's meaningful. But the things of this world, whether it's a good thing to do or bad thing to do, it has no meaning to it, and it means and profits nothing to you, Father God. So help us to be reminded of these things, Father God. Heal our bodies, Father God, from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet. We bind and rebuke sickness, diseases, infirmities, plagues, calamities, premature deaths, accidents, murders, crimes, everything that's not of you, sex trafficking, kidnapping, just everything in this world that's not of you, that will bring danger and harm to us and our families and to this world and nation. We bind it on heaven and earth, and just loose on heaven and earth long life and life and abundantly, Father God. And I just bind on heaven and earth Satan, Antichrist agenda, his false doctrine, that's any and everything that's other than Jesus Christ and him crucified, I bind it on heaven and earth and send it back to the position where it came from, and I just don't receive it. And please show up how Satan is not the, in his false doctrine and Antichrist agenda, is not the way, Father God. Show them up how it won't give you hope, how Jesus is the only hope that our heart desires and crave, Father God. Help us all to know that this world and this life is all about Jesus, that it's not about us, it's not about how we feel, it's not about what we want, but Jesus, Father God, because his perfect sacrifice was so amazing, and it was just something that he didn't have to do, and it was just, he died and felt all of that just for us. When he didn't know sin, he knew sin when it was put on him on the cross, and he bore our sins and took our place. So have us to always give thanks and just want to learn more about the cross, Father God, and want to tell others about the good news of what Jesus did. Have us never to let the cross go in vain, Father God. And I just ask you to keep us, be with us, Father God, and just have us to do your will and not our own. And just, Father God, just keep us in perfect peace, Father God. We ask you, Father God, to just loose on heaven and earth your peace that passes all understanding, peace, love, and a sound mind, and your unspeakable joy for each and every one of us. And just heal us, be with us, Father God. Loose on heaven, earth, your endurance. and everything that we may receive by being the children of God. Father God, help us not to see people the way that we see people, but the way how you see people, Father God. And just everything that we're in need of, Father God, as we're praying, Father God, we ask you to move mountains, to Father God, to break yokes and bondages, and to just come through for whatever, Father God. We ask you to do it by the blood of Jesus, in Jesus' name. And I believe that everything, Father God, that we are praying for has already been done on the cross more than 2,000 years ago. Just give us the wisdom, knowledge, understanding, revelation, faith, patience, and endurance to continue to believe that our prayers are answered until we see the manifestation of our answered prayers. And we thank you, Father God, for already doing it. And I declare and decree that it is done by the blood of Jesus shed on Calvary more than 2,000 years ago. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. So I just want to thank you guys for so much. Thank you for the prayers. Thank you for the views. And just to help others. And if they would like to join for worship, please comment, share, like, hit the ring, hit the doorbell to subscribe, and just let others know so they can also feel that they're not alone, that we can worship with each other, we can have prayer, and any prayer requests, drop it down below. And be blessed, and love you guys, and Jesus loves you more.